The Military Bowl, number 22, Penn State against number 11, Virginia Tech, here in Washington, D.C. Let's see what's going to happen. We are in our nation's capital, the Military Bowl, presented by Norman Guthrie, between the Penn State Nittany Lions and the Virginia Tech Hokies. Frank Beamer and what originally should have been a battle between the all-time one coach that's been at his team the longest tenured coach at one team in history against the second longest tenured coach at any team in history, easy for me to say, between Penn State and Virginia Tech, between Frank Beamer and Joe Paterno. But of course we all know why that isn't going down. But instead, we still have a really good BCS Playoff first round bowl game between the Hokies and the Nittany Lions, where the winners will go on to the next round to either meet Big East co-champions, the Cincinnati Bearcats, or the Arkansas Razorbacks, a team that made it all the way to the Final Four. There you see the flyover here at RFK Stadium. We are in our nation's capital. It's a cold day in December here in Maryland, but both of these teams, they are cranked up. They are ready to go. And you see Derek Moyt down on the field along with interim coach Tom Bradley. Getting things ready, getting things stretched out down there. What is a cold day wide receiver? And the man that's had a relatively good year leads his team in receiving yards and receptions. 40 receptions for almost 700 yards and 3 touchdowns. And we are underway for the Military Bowl. And a knee in the end zone is how we're going to kick this one off. We've had some pretty good bowl games. If you haven't watched the other two before you've seen this one, this is your spoiler alert, giving you a warning. Right now, we're going to tell you that, of course, we know that TCU, once again, absolutely hammered. For some reason, just can't get past those early bowl games. Clemson, they're on to the second round. And in the NIT, the most exciting game we've had so far this bowl season, Georgia Tech is on to the second round. And they've already announced that they want to play in the Cure Bowl in the second round against either Rutgers or Tulsa. But we're here, Military Bowl time, number 11 versus number 22. And now it looks like we're into a passing situation. Indeed, we are for Logan Thomas. Thomas with all kinds of pressure in his face, heaves it down the field. It is caught for a Hokie first down with pressure up in his face. Could have almost gotten a hands to the face penalty. That is absolutely a clutch play by Jared Boykin, the senior who brings that one in. And for Boykin, he is the man that leads his team with receptions, 57 receptions for 700 yards on the year and 5 touchdowns. That's a pretty good way for the Hokie Birds to start out. And one, though, not so much, knocked away. Second and 10. Pass completed just shy of the first down line. So that'll bring up a third down and 3 and maybe a running situation. Who knows? We'll see. ACC is getting some of the early matchups here. We've already seen the ACC compete, and they're actually already 2-0. The ACC with Clemson and Georgia Tech's victories. Already in the Bowl Championship Series, the ACC, the Atlantic Coast Conference, they are 2-0. And they're looking like they can go to 3-0 with the way this drive has started. That is a first down by running back David Wilson. 1,627 yards on the year and 9 touchdowns. Thomas out of shotgun. Thomas options out, and he's going to go down. Quarterback sack. Looking for the option play, and just 3 Nittany Lions there. Such a shame everything that happened with Penn State and this season. We could have seen Joe Paterno, the longest tenured head coach, against the second longest tenured head coach in Frank Beamer. Can you imagine Paterno and Beamer on this field today? But instead, we have our great... Oh, that's going to be a Virginia Tech touchdown. That's in there to Boykins. And that is going to be touchdown number six on the year for Jarrett Boykin. And the Hokies are off to a great start, a wonderful opening drive. As here at the Military Bowl, we have our personnel, of course, from Washington. We have the great military, the Army. The Army, the Marines, the National Guard. And we want to take a second look at this, a booth review, and I'm not sure what they're looking at, whether or not he dropped it or what. Personally, I can't see why that's a booth review. Let's go back to Ed Hockley Jr. if we take one more look. But yeah, the Army, the Marine Corps, so many of our great men and women in the armed forces are here for this Military Bowl game between Virginia Tech and Penn State. So the play will stand. Not sure why it's under review to begin with. Last season, we had a really good Military Bowl between Ohio State and UConn. It was between the Big Ten champs and the team that would eventually go on to win the national championship, going up against the Big East co-champions. That one came down to one final play where Terrell Pryor worked his magic. Now it'll be up to this Penn State Nittany Lions team to work their magic. Again, interim head coach, defensive coordinator Tom Bradley. And let's see what McGloin does. Matthew McGloin. McGloin's going to screen it out on the first play of the game, and that's going to be a tackle for a gain of 1 yard. Screened it out to number 25 on the play, and that was Silas Redd, the running back, sophomore running back. Second down and 9, McGloin back to pass. McGloin's going to screen it again out to Redd. Hey, it didn't work on the far side. Let's try it on the near side. Well, that didn't work either. So now on third down, why not cut out the middle man? You're going to have to throw it deep, and you see the cold breath coming out of these players. It is a cold one here at our nation's capital here, Washington, D.C., RFK Stadium, home of the Nationals and home of the 2011 Military Bowl. We've already crowned two bowl champions this year, McGloin. That one's going to be incomplete. We already know our Beef O'Grady's bowl champ. In fact, we've already crowned two bowl champions this season, and they're both from the ACC so far. The 2011 Beef O'Grady's bowl champions in the Clemson Tigers. They will await either Alabama or NIU in the second round. And for Georgia Tech, they are your 2011 BBVA Compass Bowl champs, and they await either Tulsa or Rutgers in the second round of the NIT. The Hokies, first and 10. Screen pass, that one is knocked away. Really good defense by Chaz Powell. This team, they are competing in the both teams are competing in the Oklahoma State bracket. They are in bracket number 3. Down the field, completed pass for a Hokies first down. And they are matching up with Oklahoma, Houston, Arkansas, Cincinnati, and of course Oklahoma State and Arkansas State here in bracket number 3. First and 10. Plenty of time, lots of time. Completed pass again, Logan Thomas to Jarrett Boykin. He's already grabbed it 3 times, 73 yards and a touchdown. He wants another score. Where is the Penn State defense? That time, Thomas goes down, quarterback sack. And he was sacked on the play by Jordan Hill, defensive lineman from Steeltown, PA. The Nittany Lions coming into this one having lost 2 of their last 3 games. Tosses it out to the running back on that play. That was David Wilson. And now they have to settle for the field goal. It'll be a field goal of 29 yards by Cody Jornal. Pardon me. I thought he got that. That one is going to be no good. I'll get these names down eventually. Not professional here. I like to pretend I am, but I'm not a professional, and I will get these names wrong from time to time. So a big advantage by Penn State as for the first time this season from 20 to 29 yards. Gurnall misses the field goal, but as long as the Hokies defense keeps playing that good, McGloin won't have anywhere to go. And that was just a great cornerback blitz by Jerron Hosley to come down and knock McGloin to the turf. And that is Mosley's first sack of the year. Virginia Tech is in this one, having to deal with some several injuries on the defense. A couple of defensive linemen out. And, of course, you know about Gavea Winslow, one of their top linebackers, been out for the season. That one was in dangerous territory of being intercepted and taken back for score by Kyle Fuller. Third and three, and McGloin is down again. Man. 1-2, and it would have been a third Hokie. So now they're going to have to punt it away. McGloin hasn't gotten the offense moving yet on this one, on this game. A couple of stalled out drives, couple of three and outs on that drive. He went down twice. Can't fault McGloin on that one. That's the offensive line that broke down. Down he went twice. Back onto the field comes Frank Beamer's Hokies. Play action fake and a throw. So Logan Thomas, who's already thrown for 2,700 yards this year, 19 touchdowns, is willing to keep it in the air, and he tossed that one out to the fullback, Josh Oldsby. Option. No go. And that should be the end of quarter number one. Optioned it out to David Wilson, the running back. So we hit the end of the first quarter at the Military Bowl, presented by Norman Guthrup, who I believe is a law firm. But our military personnel, they're braving the element, braving the cold weather. What's been an exciting first quarter? Number 11, Virginia Tech 7, and number 22, Penn State 0. Oh, man, inside the red zone. Logan Thomas to wide receiver, who's a wide receiver, Danny Cole. And he has had a pretty decent season this year. 52 receptions, leads the team in yards with 787 yards, 3 touchdowns for Danny Cole. Fade pass to the far side of the end zone, incomplete. Second and 10. Hokies are on the verge, making it a two-score game. Back to pass. End zone. Touchdown, Virginia Tech. And there's Cole again. Danny Cole. Touchdown, number 4 on the year, and that's Logan Thomas's second touchdown grab. To bring the Hokies up 13-0 in the Bowl Championship Series playoffs. Can the ACC make it a three-game sweep and go 3-0 in these bowl games? McGloin and Nittany Lions interim head coach Tom Bradley has a whole lot of work to do in this one. Relatively short trip for both of these teams, for Penn State and Virginia Tech, to come to RFK Stadium here. McGloin is going to run it. He says, heck, if my receivers can't get open, I'll try to do it myself, but he's going to get stopped for a loss of yard. Both of these teams have enjoyed a bunch of bowl festivities here, and that's what the Bowl Championship Series is all about. Give these Great student athletes, a fun week of vacation. Let them see a city and a town they've never seen before. Do all kinds of fun stuff. They've been bowling. They've visited some of the military personnel. They've been able to go and help some kids and donate some things to kids. And if you win, you get rewarded with another week of vacation. McGloin cannot connect with his receiver. That one gently will fall to the turf. Incomplete. He was looking for his intended receiver, Derek Moy. The 3rd and 11, McGloin desperately trying to get the offense going. That might do it. Let's see. Incomplete defense on that one from Virginia Tech. Number 17 cornerback Kyle Fuller. And once again, it's 3 and out for Penn State University. And a punt that's just going to sail right out of bounds. So the Hokie Birds, they take back over. Already in Penn State territory. Can't ask for any better field position for that if you're a Hokie fan. Inside handoff. Oh, down the field. He's got some green ahead of him. Breaks a tackle. Finally knocked out of bounds at around the 13-yard line. And that is running back David Wilson, the junior from Danville, Virginia. 5'10", 205 pounds. And the Hokie Bird thinking that they're going to go up by 21. This is looking like a Clemson beating that we saw just a few hours ago against TCU. Once again, the running play to Wilson. Enough for a yard. 2nd and 9. Pitch it out to Wilson. Wilson has a lane, and that's a Virginia Tech Hokies touchdown. It is 20-0, Virginia Tech over Penn State, and you just got to credit really good blocking. Wilson put the head down, and the blockers did the rest, and Frank Beamer's Hokies are walking all over the Penn State Nittany Lions, and they are not liking it very much. Virginia Tech is 3 for 3 in scoring on all of their drives. On the other side of it, for the Penn State Nittany Lions, David McGloin and the rest of the team, they have gone 3 and out, 3 out of 3 times. Pardon me, Matthew McGloin. I don't know why I said David. I was probably thinking of David Wilson who just scored, and I said David McGloin. Matthew McGloin. I told you, I'm not a professional. McGloin on the handoff to Red. The passing game isn't working. Let's try to get the running game going. Silas Red is able to get 4 yards on the carry. Brings up 2nd down and 6. We got going on the other station, the Belk Bowl. And that one is between South Carolina and Texas. One of the controversial picks, two controversial picks. South Carolina and Auburn, or excuse me, Georgia, or excuse me, Texas and Auburn getting voted in with 7-5 records after both being demolished on the last game of the regular season. And that Silas Red run gives the Nittany Lions their first down of the game. And now we're starting to move the ball. So throw the game plan out that we originally had. Let's start running it, and that's been working. David McGloin. Not David McGloin. He opts out the Cyrus. I apologize, ladies and gentlemen, listening into this game. I'm trying to get my composure, get my words. Matthew McGloin options out the Silas Red. 6 yard. Hopefully you're having about as good time as I am trying to announce this thing. They give it to Red again. Silas Red. And that's going to be just past midfield. And actually, that was the running back, Stephon Green, the backup running back, comes in for Red. It looks like Red needs a breather. First down, Nittany Lions, the second one of the football game. So now they're starting to roll. Get some points on the board before this half is up, and we'll have a whole new ball game going into halftime. T. take the ball out of McGloin's hands and keep it on the ground. The Hokies have not been able to stop this Penn State run. Now they're going to let McGloin throw. He's pressured, but McGloin is able to find a receiver. That was really nice by McGloin in the face of pressure. Take the hit and to get it out to the tight end, Brian Irvin. Another completed pass. That one will be good for another Penn State first down into the hands of Justin Brown. Justin Brown on the year, 400 yards receiving and one touchdown. First and 10, McGloin empty back, empty set in the backfield. Completes it for a first down, and the Nittany Lions, they are rolling. That one was into the hands of the wide receiver, Curtis Drake. Red gets 5 yards on that run. McGloin knocked away. Third down and 5. Again, empty set in the backfield. McGloin pressured. End zone. Incomplete. That's just stand-up defense. Bend, but don't break for the Hokies. Field goal is good for Penn State. So they somewhat cut the drive down to the Nittany Lions. They're certainly hoping for the touchdown. I'm sure at this point they'll just take any points on the board that they can get. As the ACC is trying to make it 3-for-3 so far in the playoffs. Last year, in the Final Four, it was 2 Big Ten teams, and technically 3 if you consider Nebraska, who moved from the Big 12 to the Big Ten. That's going to be a 3-yard gain. Only the year that we had the most teams clambered up at the top was in the first year we ever did the Bowl Championship Series, 2007. 3 SEC teams in the Final Four. And oddly enough, didn't even win the national title that year. Georgia and Texas in the national championship, and Texas got the win in the Superdome. So they're content to let this one... Nope, they're going to do one more play. I don't see the point. Yeah, I didn't see the point of that. So let's head to the locker room. I'll try to get my composure at the half. It's number 11, Virginia Tech 21, and number 22, Penn State 3. We'll be right back, fans. Welcome back, RFK Stadium. The shadows are starting to move in, and Virginia Tech, who's remained dominant, they've successfully scored 3 times on 3 drives. They were once missed a field goal, and the time expired on their last drive, and we're taking a look at it right now. Touchdown, touchdown, and touchdown run, and that's been about the reaction right now. The Penn State defense in that first half is what just blew past us, and you're taking a look at interim head coach on the sideline, Tom Bradley, wearing the old suit and tie, perhaps in memorial, in memory of former coach Joe Paterno. And this would have been a battle of longest tenured coach versus second longest tenured coach. But unfortunately, the situations, everything went down. It's not quite going to happen, but still 2 really great traditional teams battling it out. After a not-so-successful time passing the ball in the first half, they've been doing this, running the ball with Silas Red, and he's been shredding up the Hokie defense, the offensive line, opening up a gap, and you could drive a semi right through that thing. That's how open that was for a first down. Huh. Quarterback sack. McGloin goes down. That is his fourth sack. And McGloin right now having words with his offensive lineman. Matthew McGloin, he's got to be getting irritated because he wants to get the passing game going. And for as good as the offensive line has done in running, they're giving him no time to throw. Play action this time. Lots of time. No excuses there, but McGloin tosses it right into coverage. And that one is incomplete, and he's lucky it wasn't intercepted by Eddie Whitley, defensive back from Charlotte. Speaking of Charlotte, for the Belkles one, and that would have been Whitley's third interception of the season. McGloin is going to go down once again. Sack number five for Matt McGloin. He was brought down by defensive tackle Dwight Tucker. And that's, of course, a defensive line that's in there because of Dwight Tucker, who's only in there because of injuries to other members of the team. That defensive line has really taken a hit this year from Virginia Tech. Let me get this injury report, pull it up. I mean, defensive linemen, Battle has been out. Antoine Hopkins has been out. They're missing two linebackers, Bruce Taylor and Gavea Winslow, and that's why Dwight was in there, and he came through in a big way. And another man that's coming through in a big way is the running back for the Virginia Tech Hokies, David Wilson. Second and two. Back to pass. On a second and two, completed. Nittany Lions weren't expecting a pass play at all. Boykin was. He nabbed it for a first down, and we're well on our way. Is Logan Thomas to a 200-yard passing day. Ball at the 35-yard line. This is just a beating right now. Look at the time that he's got. Oh, incomplete. That could have been a game changer. Those are the plays that you have to have. Cornerback Steven Morris can't bring it in. So it'll be second and 10. Morris should have nabbed that interception. That would have been his first interception of the season. Incomplete pass, and now Virginia Tech starting to rest on their morals a little bit. Thomas can't find his receivers, and if they get stopped here, opens things up for the Lions on third, on their set of downs. Third and 10. Thomas. First down, indeed it is. That is going to be a easy Hokies first down. And that one was completed to Marcus Davis, wide receiver. 500 yards receiving after catching that one. End zone, batted away. Nittany Lions defense, for as much as they struggled, they are still fighting. Malcolm Willis, the safety from Maryland, so his home state. I'm sure he's got family here at this game watching him. Thomas, pressure, completes it anyway. Fighting for the end zone. Not quite there. But tons of credit for Danny Cole, who's had a really good game. Look at him, not giving up. Two guys on him. He wrestles all the way down to the one-yard line. And now at this point, if you're Virginia Tech, you either let your cornerback Thomas run it in, or you just give it to David Wilson. Well, maybe it'll be Beamer ball. Let's see. What can Frank Beamer do? Maybe he'll... Yeah, this is Beamer. No, it is going to be a running play. Touchdown for Thomas. And the Hokies will take a 27-3 lead. And this is just dominance right now by Virginia Tech. And it's going to be scary if they move on to the next round. It's looking like they are. Because for Virginia Tech, they're going to have to meet up with either Cincinnati or Arkansas. And, I mean, I think either one of those teams, Virginia Tech, has the ability to do battle with and take down. At the number, you might not think much of them at an 11 seed. They've lost twice to Clemson. But, I mean, they're a team that can be scary good, and they're proving it right now. Game tracks. Yeah, that's been game tracks. Nothing but McGloin seeing green. Down he goes again and again and again for the Hokie defense. These aren't replays of the same sacks. These are different sacks. 5 sacks. That wasn't just one sack played over and over and over, no. That was several different sacks all put together in one highlight package. That's how many times the groin's been hit. Hand off to Red. Rhett trying to get things going. He'll get 9 yards, and that's been the one bright spot for the Nittany Lions today at the Military Bowl has been the running game, has been Silas Red. And it's desperation time because they're going to need 4 scores, and they got about a quarter and a half to do it. But anything is possible. 4 wide receivers. They give it to Red again. Red tries to get away from the coverage, and he's going to go down. The offensive line breaks apart again after the Lions have been struggling in this game. 3rd down and 4 for Penn State. Matt McGloin across the middle. 1st down to midfield. And finally, some positives out of this passing game from the Lions. Justin Brown is able to nab that one for the 1st down. Justin Brown, the 2nd leading receiver on the team right after Derek Moy. And then you got Devin Smith, of course, Sean Kersey, Curtis Drake. Those are your receivers down the line. Military Bowl again presented by Norman Guthrup. Here from our nation's capital, McGloin, handoff to Red. We have our 1st flag of the game. Ed Hockley Jr., take it away. Holding call is going to bring him back 10 yards. How good is Ed Hockley Jr.? Not only does he do every BCS playoff game, he's somehow able to be on 2 networks at once. We just got done doing games in Tampa in Birmingham, and now he's all the way up in a matter of minutes in Washington. It's just amazing how good this guy is. But he is the son of the great Ed Hockley. So you would think that he has something special. He's like Tebow. There's just some magic about him. 2nd and 14 after that unsuccessful run by Silas Red. And they're going to go back to him again. And one more time, Silas Red hits the turf. In on the tackle was linebacker Alonzo Tweedy. That's a great name. 3rd and 14. No backs in the backfield. McGloin, receiver. And it's going to be just shy of the 1st down. About 3 yards shy. And is it 4 down territory? Tight end Brian Irvin had to nab that one. Is it 4 down territory for the Nittany Lions? Indeed it is. They are going to go for it. No choice but to go for it. Pitches out to Red. Silas Red, 1st down, Nittany Lions. Trying to get their 1st touchdown of the game. Can they do it? And if they do, that's a possible swing of momentum. Momentum is a crazy thing. Virginia Tech's had it for a majority of this game. Can the Nittany Lions grab it back? That's backup running back in the game for Penn State, Justin Brown. No, it's Green. I'm looking at receivers. Yeah, Stephon Green. I told you I'm struggling today on this game. This is the end of the 3rd quarter. Virginia Tech 28. They've been dominant over Penn State. Both of our BCS playoff games have been dominant so far. The closest game has been that NIT game. What will the 4th quarter bring us? We're about to find out. You see the shadowy effect as we're rolling in at about 6 o'clock now here at RFK. We got a penalty. It's probably going to be a holding call. Usually what it means when the flag's thrown that quickly from the line. Thank you, Ed Hockley Jr. So we'll knock it back to 2nd and 20. You see the look on the Nittany Lions' face. That's just been the kind of day it's been, unfortunately, for this team. We're hoping for a big run through everything they've been through this season. They're hoping for a big BCS playoff run as maybe a little bit of a cure for what happened this year. but it doesn't look like it will be. But let's not speak too soon, because they did complete that one, and now they're back to a respectable 3rd and 4. Do you dare give it to Red, or do you throw it? They are going to give it to Red. Red's got nothing. This offensive line's just been terrible today. Absolutely terrible. Tweety. You see him there. Was in on the tackle. Fourth and 6. Can they convert it one more time? McGloin. This time the offensive line doing great. And that's going to be a first down, so the Nittany Lions will convert once again. That makes it first and 10. McGloin to Brown. So first and 10, but now you got to score because you're down by 4 touchdowns. McGloin, end zone. Incomplete. In on the coverage of the Hokies was Fuller. He's been all over the field today. Fuller is full of it today. 2nd down and 10, McGloin. To Stephon. He wants a face mask. He's not going to get it. Stephon Green. They give it to Red this time. That's going to be enough for a first down. Temporary stop the clock. It's a really nice drive, but at this point, you guys score quickly. You've got to score quickly. McGloin, that one's caught at the 10. That's not going to stop the clock, so we got to go no huddle. No backs in the backfield for Matt McGloin. He's going to send a guy in motion. That was a quick little motion, though. Pressured, open, intercepted. That's going to be the ball game. Picked off by the Virginia Tech Hokies. And that one was linebacker Barquell Rivers, who I believe is in there for Gabea Winslow. Correct me if I am wrong, Hokie fans. But he is a senior. That's Barquell Rivers. And that's interception number 2 on the year for Rivers. And right now for Virginia Tech, it is a run-out-the-clock situation for the Hokies. Hands off to Wilson. He's going to get 6 on the run. So for all intents and purposes, this is going to be ACC victory number 3 in the Bowl Championship Series. Well, 2 in the Bowl Championship Series, 1 in the NIT. But what a start for the ACC. And maybe they can pull off what the SEC did 4 years ago. 4 years ago, the national title game was in New Orleans. At the Superdome, it was 3 SEC teams in the finals. Could the ACC be heading that way? Could we be seeing just a whole bunch of ACC teams lining up to do that game at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome? 3rd down and 3 for Beamer. I'm sure Joe Pa's at home watching this game and probably not too happy with the way his team performed today, but you've got to be excited at the way that this team performed all year long. They got to this point and got to match up against a really good Virginia Tech Hokie squad. And for Joe Paterno, I'm sure he wants to see his team with 1 minute left go down the field and get a touchdown on the board. If anything else, for Penn State, for Joe Pa, let's get some points on the board. They're going to have just under a minute to do it, but they will have all their timeouts. Pretty short game we've had here today, I guess because of the high scoring, the fact that Penn State's had to run it the whole bunch, the clock has really ticked down. 44 seconds, 3 timeouts, It's pretty academic at this point that the Hokies are going to move on to the next round. 3rd ACC team to pick up a victory, 2 in the BCS and 1 in the NIT. But it's all up to McGloin. Let's see if the Nittany Lions can make it interesting. That was a good job by Smith to or by Brown to keep the foot inbounds to get up the first. But Penn State fans, they haven't left. They're still here. They are loyal fans, and we know all about the loyalty of these Penn State Nittany Lion fans. First down and 10, ball at the 50-yard line. Plenty of time for Penn State to get some points on the board. McGloin. That one was knocked away. Collins with the tip. J.R. Collins, sophomore from Stafford, Virginia. Second and 10. They give it to Red. The opening by Silas Red, who's had a really good game. I'm interested to see his numbers when we head into the postgame show. We like to take a look at the stats and everything for you guys. So I'm sure he did really good. No, this time McGloin's going to keep it. Beautiful job faking it for McGloin to pick up 4 yards. In the back, in shotgun, 5 wide receivers. McGloin's going for the blue. Touchdown, Nittany Lions, and that touchdown, I have to believe, was for Joe Pa. Matt McGloin to Devin Smith. Touchdown, Nittany Lions. Smith's third touchdown of the year. And that football has been brought to the side, and I have to believe that that's going to end up possibly in the house of Joe Paterno, who couldn't be here today, but I'm sure watching this one from his couch at home. The effort that Penn State put up here today, and Penn State, a program that's in shambles right now, is hoping for a big run in the playoffs to maybe kind of heal the wounds just a bit, but it's not going to happen. You got to give your props, though, and congratulations to Virginia Tech. Here comes the onside kick from Penn State. And that's going to be fielded, and that will make it official. Good job on the Hokies hands team by Danny Cole. Again, Danny Cole all over the place today. Here comes the knee victory formation. You see them form the V. Logan Thomas takes the knee. Time will wind down, and we got to send our congratulations. The Virginia Tech Hokies, they make it to the round of 16. They are moving on in the Bowl Championship Series playoff. 28-10 is your final score for Frank Beamer and his team. Let's take a look at it. There it is. 28-10. What was our play of the game? I believe that was the score that made it 21-0 by Wilson. From the beginning of this game right through to the end, it was nothing but domination from the Virginia Tech Hokies, and that's just a, what do you say, a staple of the Frank Beamer program when he runs here. Logan Thomas, 14-20, 220 yards passing. Great day for him. Matt McGloin, Rustin, and Nittany Lions, they're disappointed. Mr. Offensive Lineman, I wouldn't even touch him because you about ruined his day with your play. Take a look at some of these highlights. That was just a great diving catch by Boykin. He had a great game. Well, the Bearcats could pull off the upset, take down Arkansas. Then Virginia Tech, well, they'll get the choice of their bowl game from whichever list is left. If not, they're going to have to wait and decide where Arkansas wants to go. Last year, Arkansas got to go to the Tax Slayer Gator Bowl. Where will they end up this year? Well, the Hokies are going to have to sit, find out. And both the Hokies and the Nittany Lions can enjoy a couple more days of festivities in Washington. And Virginia Tech, they get rewarded with another week of vacation in a new destination. And we wait to see what that'll be in a matter of days. Let's go over your stats before we send you away, and we just look at the pure dominance down the line. Nothing but Virginia Tech running away with this one. Player stats, of course, we know your player of the game, Logan Thomas. Only six incompletions, didn't throw any picks, 220 yards. And unfortunately for McGloin, he struggled. Only 130 yards, completed less than half his passes, had an interception. The man, though, Red, Silas Red, 15 rushing attempts, 65 yards. He did pretty good today, averaged about 5 yards a carry. Can't ask for anything better than that. He had a few more touches, probably would have hit the 100-yard mark. But on the other side of things, David Wilson, even better, averaged about 6 yards a carry, had a touchdown, 10 rushes for 56 yards for receiving. I mean, Danny Cole, he was all over the place, recovered the onside kick. You had Jared Boykin. And on the Nittany Lions side, Justin Brown had his moments. But other than that, not much is happening. Smith had the one touchdown. For defense, let's see the numbers. And again, I point you to the sacks and the interception. Nothing but, well, there's one. I take that back. Hill had one. But part of the reason why Thomas did so good, the lack of the sacks. But on the Virginia Tech side, we'll see one sack, two sacks, three sacks. McGloin, four or five sacks, was just punished today. And that was because of that great Virginia Tech defense, and they're doing it with two of their defensive linemen hurt and two of their linebackers out. That's more impressive than anything. Finally, we wrap things up with the team stats. Total offense, Hokies got them, almost doubled them. A couple more yards, they would have, or not doubled them, but they would have had 100 more than what the Nittany Lions had. Passing yards, definitely outclassed them. Third down conversion, without a doubt, outclassed them. Red zone efficiency, I mean, 4 for 5, and the fact 4 touchdowns out of 5 tries in the red zone, you have the one missed field goal, nearly 100% red zone efficiency. If you're Frank Beamer, that's just great. No turnovers for the Hokies. I mean, this was just an outclassed performance from beginning to end for Virginia Tech. That's going to do it for the Military Bowl. Another one is in the books, your 2011 Military Bowl champs. The Virginia Tech Hokies will show you the brackets before we send you away.